G'day folks, this video is not so much about making this part as me having a moment in time where my brain should have said, don't be daft, you can't do that. Or you can do it, but you'll regret it. Anyway, that's the part there that we're making, complete with a little washer to make up for the thread run out. And as it says there, the run out on this is not really a problem, because it's a full profile insert and it will be taking the top of the thread down. And as you can see, I need to get closer to the shoulder there, that's way off. So I went in and I changed the X and the Z offset, and I will regret it, because as you can see, it's moved closer to the edge, but it's also cutting a second thread. How ridiculous. Why my brain didn't say, don't do that, I have no idea. Anyway, you can see it's making a right mess of that thread. There it is. Not very good, is it? So, I immediately went and changed the Z offset in the program and changed the Z in the thread cycle to get closer to the shoulder. So there you can see we're cutting the thread. This is using a iPhone attached to the turret, and I think it's working reasonably well. You can see it's getting a lot closer to the shoulder. I ran a second cut to get the OD down to 15.9. I didn't have a nut for this. As you can see, the right hand side of the tool is doing the cutting in this second pass. Normally it's the left hand side that does all the cutting. Here's the final cut. You can see swarf coming up from everywhere. This part I remade the second one in the manual lathe, just turned it down. So then I had to go back to the manual lathe to do the drilling and the parting off. This is just making the washer. I drilled straight in with the 16.5 drill. Yeah, that's the only high speed steel tool I use, just for doing a bit of chamfering. Happy with that thread? That looks okay. And there's the finished part with the washer in place to make up for the thread run out. Okay, thank you for watching.